You're listening to Angelic Guidance, aka Stephanie Smith. Stephanie is a spiritual life coach, beauty guru, writer, and performing arts graduate. On this podcast, we'll be diving into topics around faith, spirituality, and how that fits in modern society. Thank you for joining us, and let's dive in.
Hey, my loves. How are you guys doing today? It's me, Angelic Guidance. I am not by my microphone, so if you guys do hear any background noise, my apologies. I'm just going to apologize ahead of time for that. I hope everybody's doing well. You know, weekend has been crazy, and the week is going to get even crazier. However, Abundance Month has started, and I am so, let me just say, I'm filled with gratitude, and I'm just so happy at the amount of calls that I received, emails that I've received from everybody letting me know that, you know, the messages that I've gotten for them, and, you know, the things I was able to see for them are coming to fruition. And I just want to thank you guys so much for letting me know this. And most importantly, like, we have to give God the glory, and we have to thank God most importantly before anybody thanks me. But thank you guys so much, because I'm just the messenger. You know what I mean? I don't make things happen. I'm just a messenger. But for those who emailed me, texted me, called me, and let me know that things are happening for them, if you guys want, you guys can. I was thinking of doing like a testimonial video, like, you know how I do with the makeup videos, and we talk about, you know, different topics and stuff like that. The empath's topic's going to be up this Friday, guys, so make sure that you guys are tuned in for that. But I was thinking of doing like a testimonial one, you know, where I can put everybody's voice notes in a video, and that way people can actually see God's work. You know, people can actually know that God is good, you know, because some people are in disbelief. And, you know, at the end of the day, it's important to hear everyone's story, and it's important for people to see what you've gone through and what you've overcome and where you are today. It's very important, and it helps others keep the faith as well, you know. So if any of you guys that emailed me, text, phone call, whatever way you reached out to me, if any of you guys want to leave a testimonial voice note, just send it to chitchat with Stephanie at gmail.com. This will be very helpful for a lot of people. It can be testimonials about, you know, things that you had to go through and how you've overcome it and where you are today. And, you know, it can be whether you came to me for insights and everything is manifesting now, or whether it's, you know, the bath remedies, whatever testimonial you have, please send me a voice note. Again, chitchat with Stephanie at gmail.com. This will help a lot of people. Okay. Weekly messages, guys. Let me just say that God is good. First and foremost, God is good, because I'm telling you guys, I'm filled with gratitude, so much gratitude. It makes me just want to cry. And I'm just so humble about everything too, because, you know, I just like seeing people win. I love seeing people win. I love seeing people shine. I love seeing people succeed. I love seeing people enjoy life, and especially those who went through so much. It really warms my heart up to see that, you know, your people are coming out of this depressive energy and they're transitioning to something great. You know what I mean? I love seeing the joy on people's faces, and I'm so happy to be a part of that. You know, the message I got from God, it was actually yesterday. I was going to do a daily, but I'm like, let me just do a weekly, you know, with that particular message. But patience is the key, and patience is a virtue. And I want, and here's what I want to tell you guys. When God plans things for your life, you know, he knows exactly the right time and when it's supposed to happen, you know. And I tell people that sometimes things don't happen when we want it to happen because it's not the right time. And had it happened when we want it to happen, the future may be different. The outcome may be different. It may not be a part of God's will, or it may be a blockage to whatever God has for you if you get your way at that moment. Sometimes we don't get our way because God knows what's best for us. And in the moment, it may feel like the worst thing. It may feel like things are falling apart. It may feel like, you know, God has abandoned you. But God knows us more than we know ourselves. You know what I mean? And He knows what's best for us. So if you guys just have patience, things are going to work out in the end. And I'm telling you, I've been a witness to a lot of people who literally came to me this week and last week telling me how much things have just changed for them over a short period of time. And, you know, so patience is the key, guys. And it's going to also be this way this week for you guys. I feel a very warm feeling for this week. I don't feel anything heavy really happening for you guys. I do see a lot of transitions are going to be taking place. You know, some of you guys, you may have felt very weak. You may have felt very drained. It could have been from your job. It could have been from, you know, whether you're a single mom or dad, or, you know, whether it's, you know, you're going to school or you're studying, you know, a lot. You may have been feeling weak and very drained, but I feel like you are going to get your energy back. You are going to get your energy back. And iron is very important for some of you guys. It's like you're drained also because you may be someone that suffers from low iron. You may have low iron. Or you may be someone that doesn't know that you have low iron. And because we are heading now into close to winter, we're in fall now, but we're getting close to winter, it's very important to make sure that you have the vitamin D, you know, and the iron. You know what I mean? Some of us, we get drained and we instantly think that it's something dark happening or we're under spells and stuff like that. But, you know, sometimes that's not the case. Sometimes it's just because we have not been taking the proper, you know, proper, we haven't been doing the right thing with our health. Sometimes, you know, we have to drink more water. You know, if it's getting cold outside, we got to make sure we dress warm. You know, we have to make sure we're getting our vitamin C, our vitamin D. We got to make sure when the sun's not out as much anymore and we can't be outside as much anymore because it's getting colder. It's like we got to make sure that we're still getting that energy. You know what I mean? And take care of yourself, guys. Your health is very important. And, you know, don't always be sitting up on the phone late at night and then not being able to wake up in the morning. And then, you know, and yeah, I'm not saying that we don't suffer from spell work and magic and stuff, because that stuff happens and people don't believe that that stuff is real. That stuff is real. You know, I was a victim of that myself. So I can definitely say that this is, I'm a walking testimony when it comes to that. You know what I mean? But also we have to make sure that if we are suffering from that and people are, you know, cruel enough to do things like that to us, we have to also make sure we're 10 steps ahead with our health, you know, because having vitamin D deficiency or lacking certain nutrients can only make that whatever we're going through worse, you know? So we have to also play our part and make sure that we're healthy. You know what I mean? So a lot of you guys, I do feel like here's another thing. This is going to be in the twin flame message as well, because I did channel some stuff for that. You know, I was talking to God earlier today, and literally, I know that they try to find your weak points. People are going to try to find your weak points. It's like when you see someone happy and you see someone, you know, their energy and vibration is really high and their aura is beautiful. You know, people will try. It's like misery loves company. People will try to like take that from you. You know, this week, guys, don't let anyone take away your happiness. Don't let anyone take away your light. Don't let anyone try to dim your light this week, because I feel like things are changing. And sometimes, you know, when you're in a good place, it's really important to surround yourself with people who are positive and not to feed into the misery loves company. You know, for example, if someone's gossiping and it's really bad and, you know, you're in a good mood, you know, work's going well for you, things are going well for you. But then as soon as you're around someone that's gossiping and talking about someone else, you feel this weird energy. Your stomach has a knot. You start feeling, you know, you start feeling nauseated and all of that. That just means that you're not supposed to be associating yourself with that person at that moment. It's not that you have to remove that person from your life. It just means that at that moment, you shouldn't be associating yourself with that energy, because they're carrying that energy and you want to protect yourself. You know, you don't want, you know, you've been going through so much and then all of a sudden you're happy again and then someone takes that from you based on what they're going through. You can't allow that. You know, you got to protect yourself. You don't, people, here's another message God was showing me yesterday. You know, I was talking about, you know, how some of us, it's like being on the spiritual journey and being empaths and, you know, many of us having gifts and, you know, being able to feel and see a lot more. It's kind of like we feel lonely and then we start looking for friends. We start looking for support. And you have to also understand that, you know, not everyone's going to be your friend. Not everyone's going to be your support. You know, God is first. God should be your first and foremost, your friend before anybody else, you know. But people will test your weak points and they will try to learn your weak points, you know, to trigger you. They want to know what bothers you, what gets to you to trigger you. So if this week you guys are in a good space, and you are around someone, or you walk around someone, or you look at something, whether you watch a video, that happens a lot. If you're in a good mood and then you watch a video and then your stomach starts to turn and then you get this bad vibe and then all of a sudden your mood has shifted, that was not a video for you to watch, period. You know what I mean? Because God is not a God of confusion or pain or misery, you know? So if you're feeling that way after watching something or after watching a movie or listening to a song or something, you know, you should remove yourself from that, you know, and keep your vibration high as possible this week. Because I'm telling you, they're going to try to test your weak points because they know that you're operating very high this week. Okay. It's going to be your high off life this week. A lot of you guys are going to feel, you know, going from feeling weak to all of a sudden feeling energetic. A lot of you guys are going to find out, yeah, you know what? You're right. I do lack vitamin D, or I do lack, my iron is low. I checked my iron and it's low. And, you know, so make sure you guys are taking care of that. Or, you know what? I got to keep water by my bed now. I got to keep a jug of water so every morning I'm hydrated. You know, like, make the changes that you have to make, guys, to make sure your health is more stable. Okay. But I was talking to someone yesterday, and I was talking to God earlier before I mentioned this to this person. And there's a reason why, you know, there's a reason why God had 12 disciples. There's a reason why God didn't, although, you know, Jesus performed miracles everywhere, you know what I mean? And helped hundreds and thousands of people. You're like, it's probably like, you're probably like, how come he didn't have hundreds of thousands of people in his circle? How come he only had a specific amount of people in his circle? It's because you're not supposed to be, you can't, you know, the journey is very lonely, you know, and you're only supposed to have a certain amount of people around you when you're on the spiritual journey, okay? Not to say that you can't be nice to everybody, not to say that you can't love everybody or you can't help everybody. No, I'm not saying that, but you also have to protect yourself, guys. You also have to remember that, you know, you need to be around those who are like you, those who operate on the same vibration as you, and anyone that operates on a low vibration, you know, that can hold you back. You know, so this week, I feel like a lot of realizations, I do see a lot of you guys are realizing that you're okay with being alone, or you're okay with having a limited amount of friends, or you're okay with not being as expressive with everybody. It's okay to be like that. It's okay to be like that. You know, you find your group of disciples and you just keep it going. Okay, you find your group of disciples and keep it going. You know what I mean? But yeah, people will try to, you know, test your weak points. You know, everybody has flaws. Everybody has, you know, triggers and stuff like that. And I'm seeing that because I'm seeing a lot of joy this week for you guys. I'm seeing even delivery of a baby this week. And I'm seeing also that someone's going to find out they're pregnant this week. Congratulations. You know, I'm also hearing something's going to come through telepathy. For those who have telepathy, and, you know, they will use telepathy to get to you. Okay, they will say certain things through telepathy that are not true. this is that are not true, and they will say it to kind of trigger you. So be mindful of that too this week, guys. If you hear anything through, listen, if you're having a good day and you go to bed and you're like, oh my God, this day was amazing, I got so much work done, or I got a new job, or I'm moving, or whatever the great news that you got, and you go to bed and then all of a sudden, you know, you hear something through telepathy and then it hurts your feelings, I'm pretty sure that it's not real. And I'm pretty sure that that's just, you know, someone that the devil's using to get to you, because they're trying to steal that joy. Okay, so when that happens this week, guys, just laugh, chuckle. Just chuckle and be like, I know what you're doing, and just laugh it off. Laugh it off, okay? Because the vibration is going to be very high this week. Very, very, very high this week, okay? Pray. I'm seeing to pray, you know, and just give your gratitude to God for the changes that are happening in your life, guys. Because I told you guys it's abundance month. Someone's winning a legal case this week, and they're getting the assets that they deserve. They're getting what's owed to them, whether it's a settlement from court, whether it's assets from a divorce, or, you know, whether it's just, you know, you may have been going through ups and downs with someone. There's a legal situation that's been going on. Yeah. And some of you guys who are going through that, you're going to be hearing good news about this legal situation. I do see for some of you guys, there is money involved and you are winning the case and you are getting what's owed to you. Congratulations. Okay. This is a very good week. And for some of you guys, I'm seeing that whatever you've been saving for, and I said this last week, whatever you've been saving for, you're finally able to get it. Here's the thing. Some of you guys have been budgeting and saving, and here's a surprise. Some of you guys have been budgeting and saving, and you just put away whatever you have, and you have not checked your account, your savings account, or you may not have checked your piggy bank, wherever you're putting your savings, and then you finally check it this week and you have more than what you expected. Congratulations. And you're like, wow, I'm definitely able to buy this new car. I'm definitely able to, you know, invest in a property. I'm definitely able to buy, you know, inventory for my business. And I did not expect to even save this much. Like, I'm seeing someone surprising themselves with the way how they've been budgeting and the amount of income they were able to save. And they're just really happy. It could even be from the legal situation that you're winning, whatever settlement that comes in or money that you're getting from that. It's kind of like you finally now can do what you need to do to kind of push yourself forward, to move forward. Doors are absolutely opening. And then for the other percentage, okay, here's the thing. Somebody may be in a hot, listen, if you guys play sports, you know, if you guys play sports, because I know there's a lot of people that play sports that do check in, be very mindful this week, because I do feel like somebody may suffer from a sports injury this week. So be very mindful, you know, or you guys may hear about someone suffering from a sports injury. This could even be like on the news or, you know, in the media, sports injury this week. You know what I mean? I'm also seeing that someone's going into surgery, but they're going to have to go to another country or state for surgery. And they're saving for that. Someone's saving for a medical surgery and they have to leave the country for it. So let's just say that you're in Europe or something like that, and you have to come to the United States for surgery and you're saving for that. You are going to have enough. Congrats. You are going to have enough. The surgery is going to go very well. And I also feel like, you know, yes, you're going to be a little bit upset here and there, because nobody wants to go into surgery. It's not easy. It's scary, but you're going to be okay. You're going to be healthy. You're going to recover very well. You are going to also save enough to get the surgery done. It may not even mean that you have to fly out. This is only for a small percentage of you guys that are going to actually have to fly out for surgery, but it may be in your same country and you need surgery. You're going to save enough for surgery. Okay, this could be cosmetic surgery. You are going to save enough for cosmetic surgery, whatever you want to get. Like I said last week in the daily message, if you are doing cosmetic surgery, make sure you are praying about it and make sure you do your research and you find out, you know, just for any surgery, make sure you find out who your doctor is, and don't just jump into the arms of the first doctor you see. You make sure you do your research. You make sure you look at reviews. You make sure that you check out credentials, everything. Okay, guys, and you pray about it. Get the double, triple, quadruple, whatever amount of confirmations you need, because God will give them to you. Okay, God will definitely give you the confirmations that you need. I see a lot of you guys, yes, you know, with love, oh, here comes the heart-throbbing news, okay? For some of you guys, I do feel like you've moved on. You're going to be going into a new relationship very soon. It may not be this week, but you may see the person this week or hear about the person this week, or you may meet the person this week, but you're not in the relationship as yet. But you may discover this individual this week, or, you know, things may finally move forward with this person, you know, where you're not in a relationship, like I stated, but you guys are kind of talking and kind of filling each other out and getting to know each other, right? And I feel like there is going to be someone that's very much upset that you've moved on. But I also feel like this person's also upset because this is a huge upgrade. You know, I feel like, as in, you may have been accustomed to dating a specific type of people. And ever since you've raised your vibration, you have leveled up. You know what you deserve in love. You know what kind of person you are. You see your own value. You see your own worth. And because of that, there's someone that sees your value and your worth as well. And they are willing to meet you on that level and that high vibrational frequency. And it's beautiful. The reason why I said heart throbbing is because, yes, you may be happy. You may be, you know, like, damn, I've upgraded, you know, but I feel like the other party that you were dealing with in the past is kind of a little bit triggered at the fact that you found someone that loves you. You found someone that cherishes you. You found someone that treats you like a king or a queen. And it's like a huge upgrade. So it's an embarrassment because it kind of reflects on, you know, what kind of person they are. It's kind of like they finally get to see themselves in the mirror and to see that you're happy. It's like they can see that the look on your face that you're going to have when you're with this person is not the same look you had while you were with this past person. You're glowing. You're shining. You're happy. You're just happy. And yeah, some of you guys, it may be this week where you go into a relationship with this person and then the past person is like, holy cow, they've upgraded, you know? And then for some of you guys, it won't be the relationship this week, but this is the week where you finally talk to the person or you meet the person or they reach out to you. And I'm telling you, there's going to be some people upset. There's going to be some people upset. This may even relate to the twin flame message. I will put it out later today, guys. If not today, tomorrow, but I have some very important twin flame messages for you guys. But yeah, if anything, it may be some of you guys are going into a union and you're finally, you know, you're finally heading into the union. And I'm telling you, there's going to be a lot of people upset. A lot of people upset. I feel like from both ends, the partner you're going to have from their end, the people that they were dealing with, they were accustomed to a specific type of people. And those individuals are very upset that they've found an upgrade. And it's the same concept with you. Your exes are upset you found an upgrade, you know? The other thing I'm hearing is, let me upgrade you. Let me upgrade you. Let me upgrade you. The song Upgrade You. So definitely a lot of you guys are upgrading in your emotional, mental, spiritual health, and financially upgrades. Like, and I know for a fact y'all upgrading because the emails and stuff I received from you guys and messages. Oh, Lord, a lot of you guys are upgrading. And I'm excited for you guys. And I'm seeing it here. Like, you're upgrading and it's to the point where you're going to be like, let me upgrade you. Let me upgrade you. You know, even with love, you're just telling someone, let me upgrade you. You know what I mean? So I'm seeing that as well. And budget and save, guys, because I'm telling you, if you guys are budgeting and saving, you are going to be able to get what you need to get. Ooh, my goodness. The chemistry is crazy with you and this person. Ooh, then we have a lot of people who are regretful. You got some regrets, guys. You know, you don't know what you have until it's gone. Let's just keep it 100. And yeah, you have people looking at you. Here's the thing. Some of you guys, it's not even like you're going into a relationship first. The other percentage of you guys, here's what's happening. You've upgraded in life. You've upgraded vibrationally. Like, your vibration is high. You look good. Some of you guys are looking amazing. Better than you've looked in years. Okay. Like, your skin may be finally clear. You may have, you know, your hair may have grown, or you may just grow a beard finally, or you may have lost weight, or you're about to go lose weight. Or listen, some of you guys, I'm telling you, you have upgraded and you have some people upset that you've upgraded. This is why I told you guys this week, like, I'm seeing a lot of happy energy. And if there's that person that comes and tries to ruin that that happiness and tries to shift your energy, don't even let that get to you. It's just literally someone is just very intimidated and they're very triggered and very upset. And it's kind of like they want you to operate on their low vibrational level. So it's like they're mad. I'm seeing, because guys, like, ooh, you look good. And it's like, you know, it's like that song, back then they didn't want you, now you're hot, they all on you. Like, I'm seeing that. That's what I'm seeing. Or this is where you're going to be. And you know you're going to be there because you're working on it. You're saving for something. You're budgeting for something. My dog's like scratching on my door now because he heard it. He's like, I want in. Not now, Leo. But yeah, guys, I'm seeing definitely, you know, those that didn't see your worth and your value in the past, ooh, they see an upgrade in you and they want you now. They want you now. But for some of you guys, there's only one person that you guys are willing to be with, or it's a situation where there's one person that comes in and they're on your level vibrationally. And you're like, yes, I'm gonna give this person a chance. I'm telling you, people are gonna be so upset from what I'm seeing here. And honestly, let them be upset. You know, you got to be happy for people. Everybody's going to get their time. Everyone's going to get their time. You know, I never understood why people would be upset at someone else's success, or I never really understood that. I always say, you know what? God knows your heart. If you're secretly hating on someone, and God knows your heart, so God will know that you're doing it. You can fool everybody else, but God will know. And it's like, why not be happy for them? Your time will come too. Don't you think that if you show positivity and you support, don't you think that the support will come right back to you? It will, you know? So when you hate secretly and, you know, or you hate publicly or whatever, you know, it's gonna, you're just attracting, you know, negativity. Your confidence is raising, guys. It's beautiful. Your confidence is raising. You know, there's a lot of people that lied to you guys. I'm seeing people that lied to you guys in the past and they had so much pride. They couldn't even admit to their own lies. They couldn't even apologize. But your confidence is, I'm going to be straight up, guys. Your confidence is eating people up. It is. But please be humble. Okay. Be humble about it. And I'm telling you, God's going to keep blessing you guys. God is going to keep blessing you guys this week, okay? Some of you guys, you're going to be overworking this week. Calm down. You're overworking, okay? Just because I say it's abundance week doesn't mean, oh my God, it's abundance week. I got to work harder now. No. You know, work hard, but don't overdo it, okay? I remember I was doing, I was talking to Virgos on Patreon. You know, we're doing the Virgos messages, and Virgos were going crazy. And I got the word maniac for them. Like, they were acting like maniacs. They're all over the place. I'm like, Virgos, calm down. Calm down, you know? But yeah, guys, just calm down this week, okay? Calm down this week. Listen, someone lied to you guys about how they feel about you. They lied to you about how they feel about you. You know, they made it seem like they didn't want you. They made it seem like you're not on their level. They made it seem like they have no feelings for you. But let me tell you something. This person is tired of being tired of being tired of lying to themselves. Okay? They're tired of lying to themselves. They're tired of it. They are ready. They're ready. I feel this is a strong chemistry. Ooh, child. Strong chemistry. Strong chemistry. And they had no idea how to tell you that they have feelings for you. Yeah, the pride got in the way, but the pride is about to fall off. They're building enough confidence now to finally admit the way they feel. They regret not telling you in the past. And let me tell you something. It's because of your upgrades and your leveling up in vibrational energy is what really, really stood out to them. It was like, damn, like, you know, like, I lied because I wanted my freedom. I didn't want to settle down. you know, and I pushed this person away on purpose because I wanted my freedom, but I didn't want to look like an a-hole, because I don't want to tell them I want my freedom, look like an a-hole. So I'd rather just lie and make it seem like I'm not interested. And guess what happened? In the time frame they lied and pretend like they were not interested, you leveled up. You know, you look good, you're losing weight, or you're gaining weight, whatever you want. You know, you're taking care of yourself, your health, and you're doing good in your work, things like that. And they're like, damn. They're realizing that you are definitely an upgrade. And if someone made you feel like you were not good enough for them, guess what? They realize now that you are an upgrade. You're nothing like the people they used to deal with. You're nothing like that. You are the person they've prayed for. Absolutely. And they regret not being real with you from the beginning. That's what I'm seeing, guys. You guys have a lot of beautiful things in store. They are going to tell you that they've lied. You may even hear it this week. They are going to tell you that they've lied, and this is how they really feel about you. So don't be surprised if you get a message and someone's coming in like, hey, this is exactly how I feel about you. I lied in the past. Like, they may have too much pride to admit they lied. But listen, if you're listening to this and you lie to someone about how you feel about them, you better reach out to them and tell them the truth. Don't be lying to them. Do not lie to them, okay? Because God knows your heart. You can't lie to God. Don't be lying to this person. Don't be lying to this person. You know, I'm telling you guys, they're tired of being tired. They're ready for you. Okay. Sports injuries. This could even be your kids, guys. Be cautious. You know, I don't want anyone getting a cast or anything like that, you know? So do tell your kids to be careful if they're playing sports this week. You know what I mean? Or make sure that they tie their shoelaces, you know, make sure. I'm seeing particularly like soccer for kids. You know, for the kids, for the sports injury, like, let's just say in the media, I was picking up more NFL or basketball, but, you know, for kids, I'm picking up more soccer. Okay. Yeah, guys, you guys have an amazing week. Don't let anybody trigger you this week. And, you know, if you're operating on a very high level, don't let them come in and pull you down. Okay. You'd be like, listen, you go sit over there in that corner with your miserable self. I'm about to go over here where the rainbow is, okay? Rainbow. Shout out to the rainbows, all right? And just keep your vibration high. I love you guys. I will see you guys either tomorrow or later today with Twin Flame. But I definitely will continue the daily messages. I do like it. I do. And I love the fact that I'm getting messages from those who are on my Patreon, or those who have, you know, my email, and literally letting me know, like, girl, you said this was going to happen. It literally happened the next day. Like, thank you. I appreciate that. And like I said, guys, if you guys have testimonies, it would really help people if you guys really just tell people your testimony, what you've been through. You don't have to say your name. You don't have to reveal anything personal about yourself. You know, it's just amazing. And it can help people really see, you know, God's work and how beautiful think it is to manifest things and to see things coming through. And it's just beautiful, you know. And keep the faith, guys. Love you guys. Bye.
Thank you for listening to Angelic Guidance, aka Stephanie Smith. Please rate, review, and subscribe if you enjoyed today's episode, and consider joining the Patreon at patreon.com/angelicguidance333. You can also check out extended videos at Vimeo/angelicguidance333. For bookings and healing remedies, please visit angelicguidanceremedy.com. Until next time, have a great day.